Hey everybody, are we ready to break some basketball tonight? Have we got to take a break from watching basketball, I guess, to break some basketball? So we've got a couple of things tonight. First up will be our second half of the case of Mosaic. So we've got five boxes of Mosaic to open. That's break number one. And then our second break tonight will be the third of a case of Select. And this will be the second third of the case of Select. So we broke a third of it already. This will be the second third, and then the final part of the case will break tomorrow night. So let's pull up the spreadsheet and take a look at who is in our first break. So again, we're doing five boxes, second half of the case. First half we broke the other night. We had some pretty good luck with it, so let's hope we have some good luck again tonight. And you will see down the left are the team names, and down the right are our winning bidder names. So everybody gets to see their name in lights. We do have one team that was unpaid, at least as of 3 minutes until 11. I stopped checking at that point because I had to get in here and get all this finalized. So we did have the Trailblazers unpaid for this break, at least as of 3 minutes ago. So we'll put that spreadsheet up again, of course, before we do the break for Select. But first up, we do have Mosaic. Oh, you're feeling lucky tonight? All right. I hope that you are lucky tonight, Alex. I want you to pull some good stuff. I always want everybody to pull good stuff. So I'm glad that you're feeling the mojo tonight. Sometimes when I get those feelings, they pay off. So here's hoping that yours does, that your feeling pays off tonight. So got everything shipped out today from I guess what was it? Probably Thursday night and Friday night's breaks, I guess. All shipped out today. So everything we break today and everything we break tomorrow, because of course, no post office open on Sunday, will ship probably on Monday, possibly Tuesday, but probably Monday. Let's go ahead and pull our parallels up here to the front so we can take a look at them first. So there are multiple colored parallels. What we learned the other night are the red ones and the blue ones are not numbered. This, of course, is a red one, and we'll flip it over on the back, but you see those are not numbered. There's a Ben Simmons red parallel. We'd like to find that one in a gold or a black. On the base cards, we're just going to kind of keep on keeping on. They'll be up there long enough for you to take a look at it, but that's about it. Oh, we have a hit already. We have Taurean Prince for the Hawks, rookie card autograph. So there you go, Hawks. That's a good way to start the break. And these, just for those of you who did not participate in the first part of this break, the way that I did it is we took all 10 boxes out of the case, and you'll see, well, on one end of these, see, here's one that isn't opened yet. You'll see that little handwritten number on it. So we took all the boxes out, all 10 of them. We put them in random.org and we let random decide which boxes we opened in the first break, which leaves these boxes in this break because these don't have any guaranteed number of autographs or anything per box like some sets do. So here's a red parallel for JJ Redick, blue parallel for Nikolai Mirotic, or however you say his last name, and then some more base. And for anyone who's maybe not familiar with this set, if you guys don't know the skinny on this, the deal is this set was produced as a promotional item, and you could only get it if you bought Replay, the 15, 16 Panini Replay, which we broke a case of. What, last week? Was it last week? Was it week before last? Recently, anyway. And that's so we could get this Mosaic. LeBron James red parallel, Kawhi Leonard blue parallel. So, yeah, you can't just like go into the hobby store and buy this or go into a big box store and buy this. It was only available as a result of having purchased Replay. So it makes it kind of a somewhat of a limited set, I guess, more so than normal, anyway. But it also means they don't give us any per box guarantees as far as you're going to pull this many whatever and that many whatever. We pulled out of the first half of the case, I think we pulled three autographs out of there, if I'm remembering right. One of them was a Steph Curry to 10, so that was nice. And then a couple of others, I don't even remember who they were, which is awful, but yet a hazard of doing lots of breaks. You forget what goes where. Red parallel for DeMar DeRozan. Blue parallel for J.J. Redick. So J.J. Redick's pulling lots of parallels. We also pulled a couple of golds, which were numbered to 10 out of the first half of this. So I'm hopeful that we'll find some more gold parallels in the second half of this case, or maybe some black parallels, which I think are the one of ones. That would be nice too. And again, if anybody's jumping in late, we're doing, this is the mosaic break, and at the conclusion of the mosaic break, then we'll go in and do the select break. So red parallel for Paul George, red parallel for Evan Fournier, and then some more base, which you guys can't really totally see. If I hold it at that angle, you can see a little better what the mosaic pattern looks like on these cards. They're actually really nice. It's when you see them in person, you'll probably even like them more than you do on camera, because it's hard to, just doesn't translate well unless I hold it at an unusual angle. You don't see the pattern all that well, and the pattern, of course, is part of what makes these special. So Bradley Beal red parallel and a John Wall blue parallel. Another thing I noticed when I was sorting after the first half of the case, getting it ready to ship out, I noticed that on all the Anthony Davis cards, the front of the card was marked as Hornets. I mean, the back was, of course, marked as it should be, Pelicans, and had the right, you know, team name and team logo on the back, but the front of the cards with all the Anthony Davis said Hornets. So I'm assuming that the whole set was probably misprinted with Hornets on the front when it should have said Pelicans. So don't know if that'll, you know, sometimes those mistake cards lead to interesting valuations. I don't know if that'll be the case for this. These are not, but just pointing it out because I noticed it. DeMarcus Cousins red parallel and a Jamal Murray rookie red parallel. So that's cool for the Nuggets. We always like to pull our rookies in parallels because that helps the value of those for sure. This Malik Beasley, this is a green. We didn't have a green the other night, I don't think. So this is, or camo. I bet this is camo, in which case it's going to be numbered. Let's flip it over and see what we've got. Yeah, numbered to 25. 10 of 25. So there's another nice hit, Nuggets. I know you probably would have rather had the Jamal numbered to 25, but there's a nice camo parallel of Malik Beasley rookie hit for the Nuggets. Actually, we'll lay the green one in its own little pile, so when we recap, we can keep them all separate. So let's hope for some more green and some gold and some black. The gold are to 10, so the green are to 25. The black are the one of ones. And then, of course, the red and the blue are not numbered. Those are the only colors that I know of. There may be more, but those are the colors that I know of that are in here. Kyle Lowry, red parallel. LaMarcus Aldridge, blue parallel. And then, of course, our base cards, all in the mosaic pattern, and all are prisms as far as I know. I haven't seen any that are not, or refractors as some people call them. I tend to call them refractors more than I call them prisms, so I always have to remind myself to say prism and not refractor. There's a Wade Baldwin rookie for the Grizzlies in the red parallel. Derek Favors in the blue parallel. And let's, yeah, see here on this Anthony Davis, you can see it down there. It says Hornets on the front of the card, like whatever. He has never been a Hornet. And then you look on the back and it's correct. It says Pelicans. So somebody just wasn't paying attention when they sent those to the printer. And yeah, made a big misprint on the Anthony Davis cards. Well, these packs, you know, again, the parallels are kind of the thing in the mosaic. It's similar to the regular prism. You don't get a lot of, I guess maybe there's probably a little bit bigger base set in regular prism. I think the base, I don't know. You'd have to look on in the details on the auction listing page. It says how many cards comprise the base set of Mosaic. I don't remember what it is off the top of my head. There's a Gortat red parallel, Greek Freak blue parallel. I want to say it's like it was either maybe a 200 card base set, but I'm not 100% sure of that. But it will say, on the listing, I always do. There's another Ben Simmons. I always do a little bit of kind of recapping up near the top where I say, what we're breaking, and I'll say, whatever about rookie years or what the hits are. But if you scroll down to the bottom of the listing, I have a cut and paste that gives more detail. And somewhere in there, it will say how many comprise the base set of this particular mosaic. There's a Rudy Gobert red parallel, a Harrison Barnes red parallel, and you hear my little kitty down there making his presence known. I don't know what he's carrying on about, but it probably means he's going to start chasing his sister in a minute. Here's a JJ Redick camo. So this one is numbered 5 of 25. So the Clippers have hit quite a bit of JJ Redick. I think you have the full set, don't you? Don't you have a red, the blue, and the camo? Well, you don't have the full set because you still need the green. I mean, the gold for the to 10, and then of course the black would be the one of one. But anyway, you've got a lot of JJ Redick, I guess, is the point. Clippers, you have a lot of JJ Redick coming. You lost me for a second on what, Alex? You're talking about where I was explaining to find about the base set. Is that what you mean? There's a Derrick Rose red parallel. A Paul Millsap blue. If that's what you are referring to, what I was saying is if you scroll down to the bottom of one of the listings for Mosaic, I mean, all the way at the very, very bottom of the listing, it'll have like the title of the product, and then there's a description underneath it that says whatever, how many cards are in the base set or what the parallels are and that kind of stuff. Oh, you mean your computer froze? Yeah, I don't know what that's about. I looks okay on my side. I mean, I can see. I've actually got two devices. The one that I do the break from, and I can see that in real time, and that is, specific to my software. And then I set up a second laptop off to my left that has YouTube, just viewing it as a regular viewer like you do. So I can see if something freezes, and also so I can see chat because I can't see chat otherwise. This is Andrew Wiggins red parallel, DeMar DeRozan blue parallel, another Ben Simmons. So we didn't have a whole lot of Ben Simmons in the. I think we had maybe one in the first half of the case. So I think that's three we've seen tonight. So, of course, we'd like to pull Ben with a parallel or some ink on him. It's Kyrie Irving in a red parallel. Denzel Valentine red. But I definitely think this has a lower total number base set than regular Prism has. So I just don't remember the exact numbers. And I don't want to misquote and tell you wrong. Reggie Jackson, red parallel. Paul George, blue parallel. And then our base. And we will run back through our parallels here in a second. Hey, Tyler Ulis. That's the first Tyler I've seen out of the whole case. Just this one Tyler Ulis. So, Suns, maybe that's a short print because out of the entire case, there's one Tyler Ulis that I saw. Just setting the base cards aside, let's blow through our parallels really quickly here so everybody can see those again if you missed them the first time. These are, of course, all the reds. And we'll do the blues and the camos and the signature hit. We got quite a few red parallels out of this one. I think more than what we got out of the first half of the case. It certainly seems like more anyway than we got originally. Oh, we did get one Ben Simmons red parallel. See, look at that. I wasn't even paying attention. I thought we had all Ben Simmons base. So we did get one parallel. So that's good. These are our blue. And again, the red and the blue, not numbered. Just looking at the quantity that we pulled tonight and the quantity that we pulled the other night, the red are definitely more plentiful than the blue, even though the blue are not, neither one of them are numbered, but there's definitely more reds than blues. So the blues are the more scarce of those two. Then we have our JJ Redick camo, which is to 25. This one is 5 of 25. And then we have our Malik Beasley rookie camo, and that one 10 of 25. And then we had our signature hit of Taurean Prince for the Hawks. And of course, that is a rookie signature. And that is a sticker auto. And that one is not numbered. So that is the mosaic break. And give me just a second to get our hits moved on down the road here. And then we will pull up the spreadsheet and take a look at the select break, as that is what is coming up next. And there is just an absolute ton of unpaid teams in here. Again, these were, unpaid as of like 3 minutes until 11. So I realize some of you may have paid for this between then and now, which there's a like 20-minute gap, but at 3 minutes of 11, anything that is highlighted in yellow and marked unpaid means that no payment had come in at that point in time. Again, I realize you may have paid in between, but of course I just have to go with what I see when it's time to come in here and get set up to go live. So that is all of our, those are all of our teams and team owners in a big sea of yellow as well for select. Now, what we're going to do here, same as we did before, I have these boxes numbered on the end. Of course, you can't see all of them. I'm going to have to hold them down here, but there's one and two, and then you can see four and five there. And then we had 7 and 10, and then 11 and 12. So we let random decide our first time which four boxes that we opened, and we're going to do the same thing this time. So we're going to buzz over here and type in our, whoops, if I can get myself on the right screen, type in our remaining box numbers, and then we will hit random, and whichever four come up there at the top. Does that say four or does that say nine? I can't even read my own writing. Like, I don't know if that says a four or if that says nine. Well, I'm gonna call it a four, but it may be a nine, but whatever it is, it's the same box. However, I can't read my own writing. I have it stacked as a four, but then when I look at it the second time, it kind of looked more like a nine, but whatever. We know which box it is. All right, so that gives us 12, 11, 2, 10. 12, 11, 2, 10. So let's switch back over here. All right, 12, 11, and 10 are all right there together. And then we need number two. So whatever this other weird box is that I couldn't read, if it says four or nine or whatever it says, doesn't matter because we're not opening it tonight anyway. We're opening 2, 10, 11, and 12 per our friend at random.org, our computerized friend at random.org. And one thing I did discover with these the other night, the reflection on these is just wicked. I tried to change the camera angle slightly to see if that will maybe help make it a little better to see tonight, but last night was just the way the light hit it was making it very difficult. I had to hold them at kind of weird angles for you guys to get a good clean look at it sometimes, and I'm hoping with the slight adjustment in the camera angle for tonight that maybe we can avoid some of that. As of course, we always want you to have a good clean look. Well, if I can get in there, you can see it's empty inside. If I can get it stacked upright, let's just move all of these back out of the way a little bit. Gives us a little bit more room to maneuver. All right, so good luck, everybody. Let's see if we can pull some monsters out of select tonight. It's Bradley Beal refractor. And again, with the base, you know, we're just going to kind of buzz through it. And occasionally, you know, I may not catch a refractor to set aside or a prism to recap. If I do, don't worry. I mean, you're still going to get it. If you see it, you're going to get it. It's just sometimes I stack it in the wrong spot and then it doesn't get recapped as a result. So for the Lakers, 51 of 99, we have a Zubac. And that is a materials hit. So first hit of the night, true hit of the night, heads to the Lakers. Maybe that's going to bode well for you, Lakers. Sometimes these things tend to come in waves, so to speak. Corey Brewer, this is a red parallel. It is numbered to 175, 81 of 175 on the red. And then our base, we're just kind of buzz right on through it. We had a real cool Patrick Beverly out of the first third of this case. Is that a refractor? It is Kyrie Irving refractor. And we have Zach LaVine, 9 of 99. I'm guessing this is going to be a signature. And it is, and it's a nice one on top of that. That is an on-card auto. Very nice hit, Timberwolves. Of course, we would have liked for that to have been Karl Anthony Towns, maybe, or Andrew Wiggins. Although I still, you know, Zach LaVine, still very, very solid hit, and it is an on-card auto. So congrats on that one, T-Wolves. Let's see what else we can find that's interesting. There's a die cut. Oh, and it's a rookie die cut of Thon Maker for the Bucks. And that one is number 192 of 199 for Thon Maker. And, oh boy, you know, Papagenius, I think is how you say his name, but I'm not 100% sure about that. This is 62 of 99 for the Kings, and also a materials hit. And look at that. I mean, it looks like pretty much exactly the same as the Lakers, right? I mean, it looks like the same color and everything. It's kind of weird, but there you go. Both that same. I guess they do both have purple in there. And their uniforms, of course, but you kind of would think it's a different shade of purple. But in fact, I guess it is not, because when you see them side by side, they look virtually identical. And this is one of our tricolor prisms. And again, I tried to remember what this pattern name was the other night, and I don't. I don't think it's the mosaic pattern. It's not the cracked ice pattern. I don't really remember what the pattern is, but nonetheless, it's for the Lakers. It's tricolor prism. I always struggle with the pattern names in Prism. So there are two different versions of Buddy here, and I saw two different versions of Ben Simmons as well. I don't know if one of them is a short print or not. Haven't been able to really determine that yet. The full body one, I think, is I'm seeing slightly less often than the closer, you know, the like mid-body one or half body or whatever you want to call it. But still, I'm seeing enough of the full body that I'm not certain that it's a short print. Greg Monroe for the Bucks and the tricolor. And Wade Baldwin for the Grizzlies. This one does not appear to be numbered. And it is a fabric hit. And at least a slightly different color, although similar. It is more blue, and the other one was, other two were definitely purple. So, we've done okay out of this box, because that's actually, right? That's three, yeah. We've had the on-card auto and three materials hits out of this box, and it's only guaranteed to have three either or, three autographs or memorabilia. So we've actually gotten an extra hit out of this box, which is nice. That doesn't happen every day. And we have a gold of Kenneth Faried for the Nuggets. So that will be numbered to 10. 2 of 10 for Kenneth Faried. And well, I've got a lot of different piles going over here. Well, we'll just start that one there for the gold. Oh, you need some heat. Okay, I'll try to give you some mojo for the heat to come out of one of these. We got a ways to go yet, though, right? I mean, we're just now on our first box of four, so we've got a little ways to go. And I think just in general, it's probably good fortune for us that we've had an extra hit in this box. Maybe that's going to be indicative of how the rest of our break's going to go. See, there you go. There's a heat right there. There's Dion in a prism for you. So there, well, see, we just have to put it out in the universe. Now, I know you probably are looking for something other than just prisms, but it's all right. It just means, you know, the universe is going to cooperate with us, it seems. So we'll just keep vibing it. And hoping that we pull out something awesome. Kyle Korver for the Hawks in a prism. I'm trying to remember, did we pull that a while ago? I said we pulled the Kyrie Irving out of Mosaic, but I think we pulled the Kyrie Irving out of Select. I said we pulled him out of Mosaic, but I don't think we did because it was die cut. So we had to have pulled it out of Select, and I just misspoke earlier and said that we pulled it out of Mosaic, but we didn't. We had to have pulled it out of Select because there are no die cuts in Mosaic. See, I told you, I sometimes get my things mixed up. Dwayne Wade for the Bulls in the tricolor. I sometimes forget what thing goes in what break. I remember pulling it, but then I don't remember what I pulled it from. But yeah, that had to have been out of Select, the Kyrie. Caris LeVert for the Nets. Hey, there's Tyler. Ty's getting a lot of minutes. He's coming along nicely. Rudy Gobert for the Jazz in a prism. But man, the Suns, not the coach, but the GM, decided that Eric Bledsoe is done for the season. Like, what is up with that? Why would you take Eric Bledsoe, who is one of your excellent players on the Suns, and just say, nope, you're riding the pine for the rest of the season? I mean, that makes no sense. No sense. There's a Kyrie Irving prism. No sense at all. So this is our second box that we're going into now. Like, obviously they were setting, you know, Brandon and stuff because you have to, they're giving Tyler some minutes to see what he could do, but Tyler had been playing with Eric. Now all of a sudden they decide to bench Eric. And the coach made no bones about it. Said it was a management decision, but I just think it's odd. Know what they're trying to do over there in Phoenix right now, but there you have it. And speaking of, there is Eric Bledsoe in the red parallel, 154 of 175. And there's Ben Simmons, and again, there are two versions of him in here as well. This one and another one that's a different picture. And I think, you know, I don't know. I don't know for sure if it's going to be a short print. There's Sabonis for the Thunder in a prism. I hold those at that weird angle when they're prisms so that the light hits it and you guys can kind of see the rainbow coloring in it. Because if it's not at the right angle, you know, I can see it, but then you can't see it. And you're thinking, what? She's crazy. That's not a prism. But yeah, so that's why I do that if you're wondering. Which you probably weren't, but hey, I'm oversharing. Brandon Jennings in the tricolor. And Jimmy Butler for the Bulls. This is not numbered. And it is a fabric hit. Nice red for a change. No blue, no purple. A little red fabric. Good change pace. I see another gold in there coming up. So we're going to have something else to 10 momentarily. As soon as we work our way to it. Oh, and it's Steph Curry. All right, there you go, Warriors. Oh, but it's not to 10, it's to 75. Why are my other golds to 10 and this guy's to 75? I guess the die cut has a different numbering series. Now, 21 of 75 on the Steph Curry die cut. And Chris Middleton, this one is numbered to 99 for the Bucks. And oh, that fabric's like almost coming out of there. Can you guys see that? It's like, it's kind of about ready to jump out of the card there. I mean, it's still in there, but it's definitely bubbled up or whatever you want to call it right there on that edge. So whoever put that in there maybe didn't quite get that final little corner tucked in there exactly perfectly. Oops, sorry. Justice is a prism. Occasionally, I don't notice them myself till I'm getting ready to stack them and I see the light hit them just right. So I'll just scoot those a hair so we've got a little more room to stack here. Patty Mills. Yeah, how about Villanova getting bounced today? Whoo! What'd that do to your bracket? Now, I didn't have Villanova going to the Final Four. Maybe on like one bracket, I had Villanova going to the Final Four, but on all the others, I did not because I didn't really expect them to get there. But I think probably a lot of people did. I actually thought they'd lose the next game, not necessarily this game, but hey, there you go. Golden State Warriors, David West, that one to 60, 26 of 60. So that is weird because these all look gold. I guess that's considered orange, okay? We'll call this one orange. The other two, to me, just look like they're the same color. But the die cut was to one number and the regular card was to another number. So maybe, I don't know. I guess all the gold is not to 10, I guess is the moral of that story. I suppose, anyway. Yeah, Arizona almost got bounced today. Here's Juan. I cannot say his last name. We're just going to call him Juan for the Nuggets. 124 of 299. Nice on-card autograph. So, how about that, Nuggets? You like that, I bet. The on-card autos, of course, are always my favorite. I prefer those to the sticker autos. Yeah, the Arizona Wildcats, I absolutely. Oops, that guy's a prism and I have him in the wrong stack. The Wildcats, I have definitely getting to the Final Four. I mean, not just my Kentucky Wildcats. I'm talking about the Arizona Wildcats as well. I have them strolling right out of that bracket up there. Jamichael here is also a prism. Right up there into the Final Four. And they had St. Mary's, man, gave them a game today. Oh, I thought for a minute they might get bounced. It was looking kind of ugly for a short period of time. So, of course, that's what makes it March Madness, right? All the fun stuff that can happen that we're not expecting. Bogdanovich in the tricolor. Let's go ahead and just move our prism up to the top. Robert Covington for the Sixers. That's kind of a weird picture. Like it, I mean, I guess not. I don't know. Looks almost like it's out of focus. I guess it isn't, but. Pull our little prism up here to the top. Chris Paul. So did we end up with. No, I don't think we did. In that break, no, we did. We got two autos in one. Yeah, we did have three out of that. We had two autos in one fabric. And the other one, we had four hits. So we're still running one hit ahead. I was just making sure they didn't take our extra hit back out of that box. Because I was going to be, I mean, like, oh man, if they shorted us in one box and gave us over in the other. But no, they didn't. We got them all like we should have. Got a lot of those tricolors. but none of them are numbered. I don't really know why they wouldn't number the tricolors, but I guess you can't number everything. This is probably going to be, we'll leave that in the back, but I think that might be kind of interesting here coming up in a second when we get to it. Dwayne Wade to 49, and let's see if this is going to be a signature. It is. This is what our Kyrie Irving looked like, except I think he was numbered to maybe 10, and this one's numbered to 49. But that's a nice Dwayne Wade hit, Bulls. That is a sticker auto, but the die cut's pretty cool. And these, by the way, those die cuts, the person who hit the Kyrie asked me if I would put it in a one-touch. And I did put it in a one-touch, but it moved around in there way too much because, of course, they're not made for a die cut. So I ended up taking it out of there and shipping it not in the one-touch because I felt pretty sure that it would just beat up the points on that card. So I did not send it that way. So FYI, I don't think that shipping die cuts in a one-touch is probably a good idea. Because, you know, the whole point of those is it's supposed to keep the corners from getting banged up, but if it can move around in there, it will have the opposite effect. Norman Powell, Prism. Nice hit for the wrong team. Yeah, I know, man. It is weird that he plays for the Bulls now, isn't it? I mean, it's hard to get used to that he's playing there. Kyle Anderson, Prism. No, there's been so, you know, I hate, sometimes you just really associate a certain player with a particular franchise. And then when they move, it just seems wrong. It seems like they should, you know, it would be like if Kobe Bryant had suddenly gone to play for the Nets or something. You'd be like, what? That doesn't make any sense, you know? It's just kind of disconcerting sometimes. I mean, some players, they can move around, doesn't matter, you don't care. And then there are other players. It's like, no, you shouldn't be playing there. Draymond Green, this is a tie-dye, so will most likely be numbered to 25. And it is. That one is 13 of 25 on the tie-dye for Draymond Green. So, yeah, we got a lot of little stacks of various parallels going to recap at this point. All right. Got another die cut hanging out in here. And J.J. Redick. Man, J.J. Redick has been like the man tonight, hasn't he? Like, how many times have we hit a J.J. Redick in the last two breaks? It seems like about 100. 91 of 99 for the Clippers. So, yeah, J.J. Redick is following me around tonight or something. Jamal Crawford for the Clippers. So it's a Clippers kind of moment. And this is material, not numbered, for the Clippers. Yeah, but it is weird, you know. Sometimes you just start pulling like a certain player, and then it just seems like that player literally does just kind of follow you around. Like everything you break, the player just seems to be in it. But it's probably just more what I remember than what's actually going on. I don't know. But it does seem like I've hit J.J. Redick about 1,000 times tonight. This is a refractor, and I didn't mention it because I didn't notice it till I sat it down. Shabazz Muhammad. This has got a thick card in it, so I'm guessing there's a materials hit on the back of this one. Tyson Chandler. George Hill for the Jazz, and indeed, it is a materials hit. And no numbering on that one either that I see. And we're just going to move this little stack of base right back there so that we have a little more of a spot to stack some things. And our space is getting taken up here. There's a Prince rookie refractor, prism. I'll get it out in a minute. All right, we have the red Dwight Howard for the Hawks. That one is 108 of 175. I want to pull like something really big out of here tonight. I don't, you know, I just, I want like a one of one, you know? I want something huge. Hassan Whiteside for the Heat. And that is a prism. So again, I know that's not exactly what you're looking for when you say Heat, but you know. The cards with the player holding a trophy are numbered. Okay, let's go back here and look. I did not think that they were, but I don't see any numbering on that. And I say that mainly because I had some the other night. And when I didn't remember any of them being numbered. And yeah, that one doesn't appear to be either. So I don't know what's going on with that. But that one was not numbered anyway. And nor was we pulled a Kobe holding a trophy the other night. And I don't remember if I have anybody else holding a trophy or not, but I know I had a Kobe because I did flip him over to see, hey, is it numbered, thinking that it might be, and it wasn't, and then that guy wasn't either. So maybe they have to be in one of the other colors, color sets to be numbered. I don't know. Oh, there's another one you want me to check besides the one we just pulled up? Is that what you mean? A different one than the guy I just found. Maurice Harkless Prism. Because I can go back through if there's a different one besides that guy. That's the one I remembered seeing. But if there's another one, I can dig back through there and look for it. That will be numbered with the white. It is 133 of 149. Let's just go ahead and pull our. Now this one is a refractor or prism anyway, for the Pistons. We'll flip him over and see if he's numbered. No, he's not numbered either. So. I don't know. I don't know about the people with the trophies. There may be some that are numbered, but I haven't myself seen one yet. Which is not to say that they're not out there, of course. Here's a Jamal Murray. It is numbered 191 of 299. Are we going to be lucky enough to have it signed? Let's see. We are. How about that, Nuggets? On card auto for Jamal Murray. And numbered to 299. I think I said to 199. That's actually numbered to 299. But still, Nuggets, nice hit. I'm jealous of you. I like this card a lot. Of course, you know, anybody that used to play for UK, I'm a huge fan. And I am a big-time Jamal Murray fan. And I like that hit for you, Nuggets. I don't know, you guys, I don't know who, if our Nuggets team owner happens to be on watching live, is that who you were looking for the Nuggets, or are you looking for someone else? You guys have a couple of rookies. I just always assume that you're looking for Jamal, because to me, he seemed like he was, well, at least at the start of the season, he was the hot one. I think maybe he's cooled off a little bit, but you've got him, you've got Malik Beasley. Who else have you got? You've got Fareed. You've got a bunch there in Denver, so it could have been somebody other than Jamal that you were looking for. I don't know. But I like your Jamal hit anyway. Kelly Oubre Jr. for the Wizards. This one is 24 of 75. In fact, there you go. Now that's at the right angle where you can see the number on it. Another die cut. And then we have for the Raptors, DeMar Carroll. This one does not appear to be numbered. And it is a red materials hit. So we've hit a ton of red materials tonight. And we've hit a ton of purple or purplish, bluish materials tonight. And we've not hit any two color materials. I would like to see a nice dual color jersey swatch come out of there, you know. Of course, I really just want to see a one of one of any, of anybody, of any player. I just want a one of one of something tonight. There's Danny Green for the Spurs. Hey, at least we have a different color. We have a black piece of material here for the Spurs. So there you go. There's a little variation. Ask and we shall receive, right? Chris Middleton Prism for the Bucks. Willie Cauley. Well, I did a spectacularly bad job of getting that pack open, didn't I? That was ridiculously poor job. Harrison Barnes for the Mavericks in the Prism. Trevor Booker in the Prism for the Nets. Ben Simmons. There's the other variation of Ben Simmons. So this one is the one I've seen more often than the full body one that we saw earlier in this break. I don't know if all the players have variations on their cards or not. I haven't necessarily noticed them all, but here's like a different variation on Malik Beasley. So maybe all the rookies in Select have two different versions to their cards. I don't know. But I think that is the first time I've seen that particular Malik Beasley. Jonathan Simmons in the blue parallel, and that is numbered to 299. Looks like it is number 99 of 299 for the Spurs. And this is our last pack and our final box of Select. So I know a bunch of you guys are going to jump out of here before we do the recap. So I'll just say now, thank you everybody for bidding with me. I always appreciate you spending your time and your money with me. This is Al Horford parallel or prism for the Celtics. Of course, we do have one last third of this case left and all kinds of other basketball, football, and baseball coming up. So I do hope that I see you again on another break. I always appreciate you having you. So let's recap our hits out of here. First, we'll do our tricolor parallels. And this again, you know, just if somebody wants to see their card again or somebody's jumping in late or you just don't remember what you hit. I always go through them again at the end of every break. And also it makes it easier if you decide, you know, to come back later and you're trying to compare. Sometimes, you know, I forget to make a note about what I'm expecting from where, and then that always becomes interesting when a package comes in. So sometimes you have to go back and watch to see what should be coming from where. And these are just our prisms, our standard prisms. We'll tell you one thing I do that's kind of a little helpful hint, might help some of you out, is when I do a break, you know, when I watch a break, whether I watch it live or recorded, I then go into my eBay, and you can go into the, like, items I've purchased section or whatever, and there's a place in there where you can put notes. You can enter a note that you type in yourself. So I always go back right after I watch the break, and I go in and put a note that will remind me what I hit out of that break, so that when a package comes, if I cannot identify what it belongs to, I can just go back and look at that note and say, oh yeah, that goes to this. Draymond Green for the Warriors was our only tie-dye hit out of this one. It is 13 of 25. We had one gold hit to 10, and it was Kenneth Faried for the Denver Nuggets. It is number 2 of 10. We had one blue, Jonathan Simmons with the Spurs, is numbered to 299. We had one white, Kevon Looney for the Golden State Warriors, 133 of 149. Had one, which I think is probably considered orange, David West Also for the Warriors, 26 of 60. We have three red ones. Dwight Howard for the Hawks, numbered 108 of 175. Eric Bledsoe for the Suns, numbered 154 of 175. Corey Brewer for the Rockets, number 81 of 175. And we had a handful of die cuts here. Kelly Oubre Jr. for the Wizards, and that is number 24 of 75. J.J. Redick for the Clippers, number 91 of 99. Steph Curry for the Warriors, number 21 of 75. Thon Maker for the Bucks, number 192 of 199. And our fabric hits, Danny Green for the Spurs. That one is unnumbered. DeMar Carroll for the Raptors, unnumbered. George Hill for the Jazz, not numbered. Jamal Crawford for the Clippers, not numbered. Chris Middleton for the Bucks, that's the one where the fabric's kind of poking up there in the upper left corner of that. And that one is numbered, 39 of 99. Jimmy Butler, of course, also unnumbered. Any of the ones with the silver border basically are not numbered. Wade Baldwin for the Grizzlies, that one also not numbered. And Papagenius, or however you say his name, something similar to that anyway, for the Kings. It is number 62 of 99. Zubac for the Lakers, that one is 51 of 99. And then our signatures out of this break, we have Jamal Murray with the on-card auto for the Nuggets, and it is 191 of 299. Then we have Dwayne Wade for the Bulls. This is a sticker auto on this one, and this is die cut, of course, and it is 38 of 49. Another on-card auto for the Nuggets, and this one, I can't say the guy's name. Juan is his first name. And 124 of 299. So that's two on-card auto hits for the Nuggets. And then for the T-Wolves, Mr. Zach LaVine. That is, of course, an on-card auto as well. And it is number 9 of 99. So that is it for this break number 2 out of our case of select. So we have one little third of the case left, and that goes up tomorrow night, and then that'll be it for our case of select. So thanks everybody for joining. I appreciate it very much. I hope to see you again soon.